The newest member of the Honolulu Police Commission has a lot to say about the police chief.
This is the KHON2 News at 6 with Joe Moore.
Good evening, and thank you for joining us on this Wednesday, the 3rd of August. There's a new member of the Honolulu Police Commission, and in the midst of a lot of questions about Chief Lui Kealoha's leadership, she's not holding back her opinion. Loretta Sheehan was confirmed today by the City Council in an 8-1 vote. She'll be sworn in on August 17th. But as she faced the council today, she made it clear how she feels about the current police commission actions when it comes to the federal grand jury investigation into alleged corruption by Chief Kealoha. Gina Mangieri is always investigating and has been tracking this story. Gina?
Joe, Loretta Sheehan took on her commission colleagues and saying they haven't done enough to dig into what's behind allegations against the chief. The commission chairman says they've done all they're empowered to do when there's been no indictment from a grand jury that's been going on for more than a year.
New police commissioner Loretta Sheehan held little back with how she thinks the commission should be handling leadership priorities.
The police commission right now could be having hearings and deciding whether the chief of police should continue to be our chief of police. And they could remove him right now.
The commission chairman has maintained they're doing everything within their power, balanced with fairness.
Under the current charter, the commission needs cause in order to remove the chief. And right now we have speculation, we have rumors, we understand an investigation is going on, but we have no cause at this time. And so everybody's entitled to due process, even the chief of police.
Sheehan says the commission should launch its own investigation and dig into details of the Kealoha's spat with Catherine Kealoha's uncle, Gerard Puana, which prompted Puana's defense attorney to go to the feds with corruption allegations.
It appears that he has lost public trust. It appears to me that he has mismanaged episodes of officer misconduct in the recent past. I would like more information about his role in the Puana case. I'd like to speak with First Assistant Federal Public Defender Ali Silvert to find out what evidence of wrongdoing or potential wrongdoing he uncovered.
Why not meet with those who publicly are saying, I took evidence to the feds? Why not meet with them to hear more about what they have to say?
Again, we're not responsible and we can't carry out a parallel investigation to the federal grand jury process. We have one eye on the department and the chief and the other eye on the city and its liabilities. And we need to protect both in terms of any wrongful termination suit that may occur if we act without proper reason.
Sheehan invoked a 1932 case involving falsely accused citizens.
We have a historic mandate to move forward and investigate the chief of police. Here we are 84 years later, and the chief of police is under investigation for having manufactured evidence and framing another human being. It's not ironic that that's exactly what happened in the Massey trial.
The attorney for the chief had this to say.
Loretta Sheehan is a very competent, a very, very bright, intelligent person, and I have to believe that she would look into this matter thoroughly before she makes any comments or reaches any conclusions with the commission on what the appropriate action to be taken, should it be taken, involving the chief.
It has to be done in a public way. The chief must be afforded every single opportunity to respond, to repair identified deficiencies, to address any identified shortcomings. It's not something that anyone or any body should do quickly or without careful consideration.
The city charter gives the commission the power to fire a chief for cause, but voters could end up broadening the panel's options.
Charter amendments would allow the commission to remove a chief for simply the lack of public trust, for some egregious isolated acts, or just if the fit isn't right anymore. So I would support it.
No one else is asked in any investigation on in the public sector and the private sector to step aside merely on an allegation. If they are independent, they're going to listen to all sides and look at all aspects of this.
Now, the council strongly backed Sheehan in their confirmation vote. Just Councilmember Ozawa voted against it, pointing out she's wanting to do things that don't match with the direction of the current commission chairman. And he wondered how that's going to work out. Gina Mangieri, KHON 2 News.